It's resting on them to reveal the mysteries. So mystery is what we're revealing out here. The mystery of what is America? Is it a great country? It is a God-fearing country? No. You're a mystery. What is that mystery? Read, brother. Yeah, come, go.
It's Amos 3:7. Surely the Lord Yahweh will do nothing, but he revealeth his secrets unto his servants, the prophets.
Ooh. That's right. Those secrets, those mysteries were revealed to the prophets. That's why we're talking out here. And you're saying, what are these guys talking about? They're reading the Bible, but the words that are coming out of their mouth, you can't receive them. Because it's not meant for you to receive. It's only meant for the Lord's sheep, the elect, for those with ears, spiritual ears. The Most High is going to open their ears and stop here and listen. Or on the YouTube, on the social media, for God is going to open up the minds of the people to see, oh, these people, these brothers are breaking down the Bible. And it fits. It fits everything politically, socially, historically, of what we're breaking down. Mystery, Babylon the Great, and those mysteries were revealed to the prophets. Not to the Catholic priests, not to the Protestant ministers. Why? Because they're all about the money. That's why they call it Creflo Dollar. Kendrick Price, what's his name?
I forgot that.
Price Dollar, all that bullshit. Eddie Long, that dude's he's with the worms. His congregation is the worms. Eddie Long, he's going home. He's in the damn funeral fucking box. So all them dudes is done for, you know what I'm saying? The only people teaching the truth and mysteries of the Bible is the apostles, the great millstone, the elders, the sincere Akim, and all sincere Akim throughout the world preaching the word of Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shah.
That's right.
So read it for the mystery. All
right, back in Revelation, chapter 17, verse 5. And upon her forehead was a name written, mystery, Babylon the Great.
Yeah, Babylon the Great. Babylon means confusion. So this is the great confusion of the earth, which is the United States of America. Why? Look at your president. That's one of the greatest examples ever in your history of the great confusion that has befallen this land. Babylon the Great has a great confused president. He's called Donald Trump. That's why he was talking shit to his gunmen out there. You know, in other words, NATO is his security guard in Europe. He's talking shit to them. Who does that? Unless you have a confused spirit on you. But that's the Yahweh Ba'asham, Yahweh Shah is giving them the spirit of straight confusion now. You know what I'm saying? They were confused going back a couple months ago. Once the election, you know, once he won, that was like instant great confusion throughout the whole land of America and throughout the whole world. Because how could you elect a person who has no military or political history into your top office of the land? You know why? Because that the president, the office of president was never anything anyway. That shit was always a position of a puppet to the elite, to the Illuminati, to the Rothschilds. So they don't care about this country no more. They want this country to fall to martial law. The US dollar is gonna fall, the microchip system is gonna be implemented, there's gonna be a lot of death and suffering on this land. So if you accept the chip, you can eat and you can buy and sell, you know what I'm saying? But the saints of the Lord are not gonna do that. The Israelites, the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, the elect is not gonna accept the chip, the microchip, the mark of the beast. So this is what's coming on the land, even greater confusion. So this is America. America rules the earth in their political, in the banking. So we know what we're talking about, that America is Babylon the Great. The mystery has been revealed, all right? It's been revealed for the last 30, 40 years by the Israelites, all right? Not by the Catholics, because they're part of the damn system of Babylon the Great, all right?
Done.
That's why when that faggot-ass Pope comes here, I can call him a damn faggot because all his ministers are faggots, all right? They don't marry. They have a policy of they abuse the kids, and they secretly put them in another parish or whatever. Yeah. That when they do that, they secretly put them in a witness protection program in another church, and they change their identity. They're damn demons out here, you know what I'm saying? They're damn Catholics. Protestants too, because you're the daughter of the Catholics. You're not anything different than them. All right, so what you got, buddy? All
right, stop everything. And upon her forehead was a name written. Mystery. Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth.
Even gets worse. You're the mother. You're a damn mother. A mother of harlots. Mother of hoe. A mother of a damn hoe. Not one hoe, a whole family of hoes. So that's all your philosophy. All your philosophy is dealing with whoredom. Right? So when I say that, that's talking about that you give yourself up to these false philosophies. The Bible is a true book of wisdom, right? Your philosophies, democracy, capitalism, all that shit, that's whoredom. The mother of great whores also trickles down to the spirit down on these streets. That's why when summertime comes all across the United States of America, bitches be having their, I call you bitches because the Bible says a shameless woman should be counted as a dog. So you fit that when you walk down these streets with your breasts exposed, with your thighs and your ass, you know, wrapped around, your secret parts are exposed. So that's why the Bible also calls you the mother of harlots. Harlots means hoes. You dress like a prostitute. Where does this happen? Where's spring break taking place, huh? Spring break. Isn't that one of the greatest things in America? Spring break. In Miami, everybody got to go to Miami. Why? That's where the harlots, that vibration of harlots and harlotdom is going to be taking place. California, Florida, down south, New York City. You know, they got the Puerto Rican Day Parade, bitches walking half naked. West Indian Parade. The harlot, that standard of being a harlot, it's not really a standard, but the example is primarily focused on America. You don't see that in China. You don't see that in Africa, even. You don't see that in the South Pacific. The mother of harlots is the United States of America, right? This has been happening primarily going back to the 60s with that hippie shit and all that, which was, you know, showing their breasts and all that. Then the feminist movement, you know, they found it pride showing their breasts. So, you know, what kind of pride is that? All right, you have breasts. So what? When you're married, you have a man, you're supposed to enjoy the breasts of a woman. And to show it off, that's like you're lowering yourself. You're becoming a prostitute. You know what I'm saying? A lot of you women is lesbians anyway. You know? That's the new thing. That's why they have The View. They ain't talking about that shit. A bunch of old hoes too. Old harlots on The View. And that view is the view of a harlot. You know what I'm saying? All across America is harlots, prostitutes. That's why they say, you know, what you got for me? You know, what money can you offer me for me to marry you and all that? It's not done in righteousness according to the Bible. So, read it from the top.
Right. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth.
Yeah, so we already explained what the abominations is. The abominations of the earth is the Christianity of America. Democracy is also abomination because democracy is against the rule of God. Democracy means mob rule, the rule of the many, not the rule of the Bible. The law, the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible. So democracy is the opposite of theocracy. Theocracy is ruled by God or God's laws. So you're full of abominations out here. It says, do what thou wilt. That's witchcraft. You do what you want. But they say you can be whatever you want to be. That's not true. Yeah, you can't be whatever you want to be. You know how many options you got? Well, you want to be a fish? You want to be a damn dog? You know what I'm saying? And some people do that. Yeah. They got people that have role playing. You know, I'll be a dog for the day. They have that shit. So be what you want to be. That's abomination out here. Anything, that's what democracy is though. Going back to the Greek Empire and the Romans, you could set up any religion, but you also have to give Caesar his due. Give unto Caesar was the rule back then. You had to honor him as a god, so, and then you can have your own religion. So the religion of the people of the earth now is do what I will. Do whatever feels good. I do anything once. I try anything once. I eat anything once. This is the philosophy of the world. That's why these women are wearing pants. They think they're men. You know what I'm saying? It don't make sense for women to wear pants. They have a zipper in front. That's madness. That's great confusion. What you got, bro?
This is... Job chapter 9 verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the face of the judges thereof.
Hi.
If not, where and who is he?
That's right. Yeah, break it up.
Yeah, so the earth is given into the hands of the wicked, and like the brother, you know, was saying earlier, the wicked primarily represents Esau. Alright, because Esau, the sword was given to Esau, the blessing of the earth was given into the hands of Esau.
That's right.
Right? And it said, he covered the faces of the judges thereof. And who are the judges? Well, beginning with the apostles, man. Well, beginning, really, it started really, well, yeah, Sophia, yeah. Yeah, the Most High, yeah, because he's going to try to put all his, you know, the image of the Heavenly Father being a so-called white man.
Yeah, that's Christianity.
Right? So, you know, pretty much that was a point, you know.
The water out there. Beautiful, that proves the point in the Bible. The Bible always backs itself up with other things that's right. So the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. That's why all this madness is happening on this earth, you know what I'm saying? Starting with faggotism, lesbianism, do what thou will, you know, role playing, what else? They even got vampirism. They've gone to such a level that they are doing things that don't even exist. You know, they want to be little mermaids. Oh, that's another thing. I seen a mermaid party. Fucking mermaid party, huh? With white women with them, I guess it's some, they fit some kind of shit, some rubber that's a fin, like a, you know, and they just swimming around the pool. So you could be a damn mermaid, a mermaid in America. That's great confusion. That's an abomination.
Fucking anal sex, that's a big thing in America. Popping somebody in the ass, that shit is disgusting.
That's a Greek culture.
Yeah.
That's part of the Roman, Greco-Roman, and it's perpetuated in this country, you know what I'm saying?
Done.
You know, they have in the movies, what was that? Susan, there's something about Susan. What was it, Cameron Diaz?
Oh, that old movie, joke. Right? I forgot, yeah.
Something about Carmen or some stupid shit.
Something about Mary?
Yeah,
I think it was Mary. Something about Mary.
Yeah, that's blasphemy right there. Something about Mary. There's a damn white woman. The big joke there, she got cum in her face. That was the big joke of that movie. Yeah. That movie wasn't really an adult movie. It was for teenagers and everything.
Done.
So they by gradualism, you know, they indoctrinate people into their abominable lifestyles. You know what I'm saying?
Those are American Pie movies, huh? Too. American Pie, the movies are disgusting.
American Pie, because the great joke of that movie is that the Edomite kid was popping a damn pie. Those movies from the 90s, late 90s, early 2000s.
Yep.
So, you know, a lot of these, this generation, but they always have a generation, they put something in the popular culture and it blows up and it stays in your mind. You know what I'm saying? It stays in the heart of the people. That abomination, that confusion. You know what I'm saying? That's a confused kind of state of mind. The Bible deals with law and order. We are the kings and princes of the earth. We don't have to deal with this garbage-ass lifestyle. We gotta return back to the divine law, the royal law of the Bible, in the name of Yahweh Shai. Right? So we can't be caught up in the folly of this kingdom. So read on, brother.
Revelation 17:6. So I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints.
That's right, so this is history right here. Not talking about an actual woman, not talking about actual people being drunk. The woman is America. When you go into the history of America, they were drunken, meaning they are. When you drink, you have you take a lot of alcohol in. You know what I'm saying? So they took the blood in of our people, the saints, the Black Americans, the Native Americans, all the tribes going down to the Florida Indians, which is the Seminoles. All right. Even in the West Coast, they killed off Issacharites, which is the so-called Mexicans of Aztec descent. But all their history, when they pushed from Europe to America and established the United States of America, they had to get drunken with the blood of the saints. By what? By the gun, by the sword, by the blade. The cavalry of the United States of America conquered the North American Indians, and the North American Indians are one of the tribes of Israel. They're one of the saints. So you are drunken. Union Square is drunken right now with the blood of the saints, huh? Because this land, this particular right here, this is Native American land. So this land is soiled right here with blood. Yeah, it's really got the Native American right there. So Black Americans too. The blood of Black Americans, the tribe of Judah, was spilled in America. So this country, this land, is soaked in the blood of the saints. Because these are the saints right here. You could get the slave name, and you could get the Hebrew name. Those are saints, those tribes, their blood is soaked in America, right? Starting with the conquest, it's called Manifest Destiny. Manifest Destiny was America spreading across the land, their abominations, their confusion, putting our people in reservations, putting our people in the poor parts of the land, the ghettos, the slums, you know? The word ghetto, when you break it down, I believe it goes back to Egypt, you know what I'm saying? Ghetto and Egypt has synonymous roots, ghetto and Egypt, why? Because our people are in a modern day Egypt, right? So the blood of the saints, just like in ancient Egypt, the blood of the saints was in ancient Egypt. In modern Egypt, it started with slavery, with Jim Crow, the Ku Klux Klan, right? The massacre of the tribes of the United States of America, the Native American tribes. Those are all the bloods of the saints that have been soaked in this country.
And I saw the women drunken with the blood of the saints.
Yeah, you got a piece of that?
No, I got the etymology of the ghetto.
Yeah, go ahead, bro.
It goes back to the word. It goes back to the ghetto. It means part of a city in which Jews are compelled to live, especially in Italy, from the Italian ghetto, part of a city to which Jews are restricted, you know, of unknown origin.
Yeah,
you
know? They know. That's why the Spirit brought it out like that. So read it again.
All right. And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints.
Yeah, the United States of America has massacred our people so much that the Bible says they're drunk off the blood. They're drunk off the blood of our people. The Black Americans, the Native Americans, who we are. We're called African American, Puerto Rican, so-called West Indian, so-called Haitian, so-called Cuban, down to the so-called Mexicans of Black descent and Indigenous descent on our forefathers' side. We are the people that suffered these curses in this country. Our blood is this land was built on our blood. That's what it's talking about. Read on.
And with the blood of the martyrs of Yahweh Shai.
That's right. It started back then in the Roman Empire, because this is the modern Roman Empire. This is the image of the beast. That image came to America. You know what I'm saying? That's why your architecture harks back. It reminds you of the Roman Empire. It reminds you of the same image of the Roman Empire. It started back then that they were killing the prophets. What is that, the martyrs? Yeah, the martyrs, the gun. So that would happen back then with Peter, Paul. Who was killing Peter and Paul and the apostles and all the first so-called Christians, which were Black? Rome. So our people are those same people. The Edomites were killing our people. They were called Romans back then. The United States of America is also killing our people, starting back in the slave trade. Those martyrs are gonna once again come back. Why? Because in the book of Revelation it says, they're going to attack those who hold the name Yahweh, Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and keep the commandments and testimony. So we're going to have martyrs also in this last days, just like when the first Christians came. It's going to happen once again. The book of Acts is going to happen once again. That whole vibration, the church is being built. That church is called Great Millstone. Right? The prophets and apostles are back. The martyrs are amongst the believers of Yahweh, Baal Hashem, Yahweh Shai. So that spirit is going to come back. And Esau, the so-called white man, they're getting that Roman spirit back.
Cunt.
That hardcore Roman spirit.
Cunt.
You know what I'm
Cunt.
Saying? He started with Trump. That's why he got that eagle face. That's why he got that vibration like an ancient Roman Caesar. That's why he don't give no fucks about even his own people. That's why he talks shit to Europeans. That's the same thing the Caesars would do. They would have beef. They even killed a Caesar. I believe it was one of the famous Caesars. They stabbed in the back 30, 40 times. So these are snakes. We're dealing with snakes. This government, these are all snakes. They're going to turn on each other, right? The militias. That's why the Bible says he's going to turn them against each other. Satan shall cast out Satan. It says the Egyptians versus the Egyptians. The white man versus the white man. This is coming to this country. So it's very important our people unite. Unite in the name of Yahweh. That's the name of God the Father and his son, Yahweh Shai, whom you call Jesus Christ ignorantly. He's a black man with white woolly hair. So we got to turn back to these truths. In the commandments, and we're going to be part of that hopeful salvation. You know what I'm saying? The salvation is coming. We should be part of that hopeful elect. That number. The number of the saints is 144,000 and one-third. You know what I'm saying? The house of David is coming back. King David is back. He came back and shall be back in these last days. So it's very important. The Bible is real. It's alive. You know what I'm saying? That's what people don't understand. The Bible is alive. This is the Roman Empire once again, and God's people is back. Prophesying the downfall and prophesying of the Messiah once again.
Me,
brother.
Revelation 17:6. And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints.
That's right.
With the blood of the martyrs of Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration.
Yeah, he wondered. He was like, wow, that's crazy. Bro. And we wonder. When we see the history, we wake up to the truth. We wonder and say, wow, so much death and destruction that it came upon our people. You wonder, because that's a great mystery and a great prophecy. Everything, it makes you wonder. And then you have to consider that this is true. This, the vibration of this country is to throw you off the path. So you don't really consider, oh, maybe, you know, you get confused because it's the land of great confusion. The TV, the news, everything is to trap you up. You don't realize that this is actually happening right now. The whole Bible is a lie. You have to really meditate on the Bible, study it, so you can walk like with a clearer mind. It says the truth shall make you free. You know what I'm saying? What's that talking about? So you get caught up. You get caught up in that gang life. That's gonna get you killed. We have no wins in this country doing that. Cause you know why? The devil's gonna lock you up. You're gonna be in prison. And then when the time comes, they're gonna try to give you a microchip. You're gonna be fucked. You know why? Cause that's the mark of the beast. So, you know, dealing drugs, they're the biggest drug dealers. You can't outsell the white man. They control that whole shit. When it's time to give up, you know, give up your soul for that. They say the devil, write the contract with the devil, they're gonna come after you. That's why they did with Scarface. And that's your idol. That's a movie. Didn't they come for his ass and they took him out? That should be an example, and that's true. That was the truth. That's how it actually goes down. But then you have some people, some people retire dealing drugs. That's true. But you know who's gonna, you're lucky the white man didn't get you because it's God's gonna get you. He's gonna destroy your ass with the nuclear bombs. So you old drug dealers, you can't escape. There's drug dealers in the 60s, 70s, you know, they did their dirt, and now they're living it up in Puerto Rico, or Dominican Republic, in Colombia, you know, in Cuba and all that bullshit. They're gonna get theirs. Unless they repent, the Most High got a death angel for all our people that did wickedness and they think they escaped.
That's right.
These are the last days, and all that dirt, which the Bible is sin, breaking the laws of the Bible, you're gonna get paid back unless you repent in the name of, I'm gonna put it like this, Black Jesus Christ, all right? We're not no damn Christians. We are Israelites. Jesus Christ's name is Yahweh Shai in the ancient Hebrew pure tongue. You got to repent in that name and get yourselves right, because martial law and Armageddon is coming fast. Truth is out here. Truth is not. People know that the Israelites are on the streets waking up our people. This is our duty. You know, if not, we got problems with the Creator. Because all the prophets knew that. Jonah, what happened to Jonah? Jonah got swallowed up by a great beast from the ocean, you know, the sea. And what happened to Jeremiah? Jeremiah was getting the vex, you know, because he might have was burning inside of him to come out and speak the word. We're supposed to do this. We were made from the womb. That's what Jeremiah, he said, you want to get them? Jeremiah from the womb of the belly was made to be a prophet. Okay. All right? Tell the people, before a kingdom falls, a prophet's supposed to come out, tell the people the truth. The truth is, these people right here are the Israelites. We're waking up as a people. We're God's children, all right? So it's our job to wake up our people. We're the great people on earth, according to the Bible, all right? If God is black and Jesus is black, the angels are black, and they're protecting his servants out here to preach the word and wake our people up. It's gonna happen till this kingdom falls, all right? And your kingdom is falling, all right? That's why you have a damn lunatic, a nutcase, as your leader. So you gotta, we're gonna prove that. Yeah, let's get to the point about a prophet is made from the womb. So this is our job. Our job is not to, you know, just get rich or die trying. You know what I'm saying? That's not our job. Our job is not to shoot 3-pointers from 50 damn feet away. Our job is not to win NBA championships or have the best album of the year. Because the Bible didn't say that. It said the greatest gift is prophecy. You know why? Because that's a great gift, because we're telling you what's going to come in the future, and there's a reward for that. We're doing it because we love the Father and the Son, but there's even a great gift for that. So he's going to give a reward, a true championship belt, a true crown on our head, a true medal. Fuck the damn Olympics. That's paganism. The true medals, the true rewards, the true crowns, and the true honor and memorial is coming to the prophets of God. The 144,000 and the 12 apostles, they're gonna sit on 12 thrones, all right? So this is what we're looking for. So we're gonna prove that. Here you go. Break it down.
So Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai and keep his commandments.
That's right.
For this is the whole duty of man. So this is what we created for. There's nothing else to do on this earth but prophesy. We gotta come back to the ways of the Most High and bring our people back to who they are.
That's right,
wake them up to who they are and stop bullshitting with all this shit in the world, man.
That's right, brother.
The Israelite man is the only man that can open this Bible and get the precepts, you know what I'm saying, the breakdowns, to you know, to call our people back through the spirit of God. Y'all about to
know
something.
That's right, bro.
Go back to that. All right, cool.
That's right, because the knowledge has come from our elders going back 50 years, 60 years. Abba Bivens, yep. Elijah the prophet, all those men fulfilled prophecy. This is why it's spreading like wildfire across the earth. It only started from one group. So we know what we're talking about. Everybody else, they're playing in the cut. They're not coming out here telling the people who they are, telling the people what's to come. Telling the people the true history, telling the people the deep sayings of the Bible, the knowledge, wisdom, understanding of the Bible. These even 5%ers, Ancient Islam, Rastafarians, all them down the line, and people are not out here waking up their people to the reality of the world. Only the prophets of God are doing that. The Israelites. We're going back to the book of Revelation.
Revelation chapter 17, verse 7. And the angel said unto me, wherefore didst thou marvel?
Yeah, because the angels tell him, yeah, why you marvel? Because, you know, sometimes the prophets used to get shook up, used to get shaken up, but these are great things to see. And, well, you know, that's why I said the prophets have waited to see these great things, but have not been able, and anybody knows that precept, that the prophets have waited to see this time, that's why he marveled. And we're living in that time, and our people is asleep. The prophets marveled at that. Even Ezra, he was fainting. He was at the point to faint. A lot of the prophets, they see, oh, wow, these are great things. We're living in it. You know, 9/11 is going to be damn baby play, kids play, compared to when they announce martial law out here. When the next terrorism attack happens, it's going to be martial law in a police state all across this country, and it's never going to go back to its former state, because democracy is going to turn into totalitarianism. And then that's when they're going to institute the mark of the beast, because all the markets of the world is going to crash after that. And it's going to be One thing after another.
Domino
like
effect. Huh? A domino effect. I got that precept. You could bring
like
it up.
You
could read it. It's Matthew 13 and 17. Done.
Now, sister, you know God is black according to the Bible?
Yes, he is.
All right, you know Jesus Christ, his son. And his son, too. Because God and Jesus, they're two different. That's the modern term for them. True name in Hebrew is what we got to learn. Because the Bible says these days, there's going to be a lot of martial law, the collapse of this kingdom. So we got to know the names of the Father and Son to protect us in these set times. So the names aren't written in the Bible. We're Israelites. The black Americans are the tribe of Judah. They're the real Jews, black Americans. King David was a black man. He wouldn't be considered an African, be considered an African American. Just like Jesus Christ. We can say that with all boldness because the prophecies fulfill the people in this country. You know that black Americans, Hispanics, of black descent, or indigenous descent, and the Native Americans. We are the Lord's people waking up in these last days. So we're reading the Bible, the prophecies, because pretty soon with the president, he's gonna initiate a war. Because he's pissing off, excuse my language, his brothers and sisters in Europe, NATO, Russia. You see all across the world, all eyes is on America, because they know that this country is falling. It's falling morally, economically, and militarily. So they're gonna try to set their order across the world, but it's not gonna work. So we don't gotta really worry about them, because the end of the world is coming, but the beginning of our kingdom is coming. God is gonna rule on this earth through his son, Jesus Christ. And he's a black man. And his people, so-called black, they're brown skin, people of color. He's gonna rule the earth, because the white man has not done righteously on this earth. We know that, the history, we know that. So that's why we are out here teaching what is right and wrong, according to the Bible. We gotta give up pork, because that's a sin in the Bible. The blood of Jesus Christ does not cover, that's what they say, right? The blood of Jesus covered me from eating pork. Even in modern times, they tell you eating pork is not good for you. The Bible told you thousands of years ago not to eat pork. So what's true? God be true, and every man a liar. So shrimp is also included with that. Clams, lobster, all that going down the line. There's a whole list in the Bible. Now that is important. You also gotta follow the instructions of the Bible to the best of our ability. I know it's hard, because we're living in a time that it's hard to, the food is polluted anyway, it's GMO. So we gotta, you know, bit by bit, practice rehearse the righteous acts. You know what I'm saying? Just knowing God is black, Jesus is black, the name of God is Yahweh. That's, it means I am, or he is. He's the ultimate power of heaven and earth. When he created man on this earth, he created him out of the dust of the earth, which is Brahm. Adam was created out of the dust of the earth. That was a dark-skinned man that he created out of the earth. The first people were all dark. So these are things that our people should be learning from a child on up. So that's why all that is going to be taught in the kingdom of heaven. But this is the beginning of it. We are the beginning of the kingdom of heaven on earth because it is about the laws, statutes, and commandments of the Bible. The priest of God is supposed to teach the laws to the people. They're not teaching our people that. That's why people don't care about themselves. Mm-hmm. They see another black man, or another Hispanic sees another Hispanic. They're in that gang initiation thing. They want to kill each other, not knowing you're killing the saint of the Lord. But this is not nothing new, because this happened in the ancient world too. Our people have, you know, lots of, you know, be sorry for, because we turn our back from God. You know what I'm saying? He's turning us back now. That's why all these camps you see in the world, I say camp, where brothers gather together and teach the people, like we're teaching the people now. This was done every time a kingdom is about to fall, a government is about to fall, God raises up young men. That's why Jesus Christ was a young black man. Then he died 33 years old. That's a young man. He was teaching for 3 years. So he started his ministry at 30 years old. All the other men, they were rough men, but they were saints. They were the saints. They were, everything they said, it might have came out rough, but it was very important for the people to wake up, to be shaken up. Because it's better to know it now than get caught off guard. Jesus Christ, a black man said he's coming as a thief in the night. So that tells you right there, he's gonna come unawares. Because the economy of this country is gonna collapse one day. And you're taking a risk. That day, everybody's gonna turn to God. You don't want that day to come. Because it's gonna be, that's definitely gonna be just the Lord's mercy that he could choose you to take you out of that. That's why God stopped you here, stopped another person here. That's why the Most High God woke us up. And now the blood, we're trying to wash the blood off our hands by teaching our people. You know what I'm saying? Because if not, we don't do this, we're done for. So everybody who stops when hearing God's word, now they can't say they didn't hear about that. They didn't know that God is black, Christ is black, and it's important. So when that time comes, you're not running to a little white image of Jesus Christ saying, Jesucristo, help me, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, that's an image, that's a false image. That's an idol. You can have the names in your mind, in your mouth. Call upon Yahweh, Ba'asham Yahweh Shah. That means in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, save me. Okay. These times are coming for salvation. You know, it's going to be martial law, it's going to be famine on the streets. These are all the things in the Bible. These are the harsh things in the Bible. There's many beautiful things in the Bible. Salvation, being saved. That salvation is coming by vehicles from on high. They call the chariots of God in the Bible. And in the modern term, they call it the chariots of UFOs, the flying saucers.
It's on the sign. There's one on the sign right there. Yes. You see? Chariots.
These are the chariots of God. The angels, they call it angelic vehicles. This is going to be the great deliverance